back this fast, Ham. I'm in a hurry, Eva Joe, a real big hurry.
Okay, you sweet thing. Now, you kids, you get your things now. Get your things. Okay, here we are. Come on. Come on, everybody. Come on. Come on. Come on, kitties. Come on. That's it. Got all your stuff now, don't you? Oh, good. Come on.
Don't waste time talking, Eva Joe. I just want to dump them and get it over with.
Well, we're here, Mrs. Anderson.
Yes, Mrs. Doyle. Children, this is Mrs. Ogle, and she's going to be your foster mother until your parents come back for you.
Hi there.
Little Freddy, Margaret Jean, you go say hello to Mrs. Ogle now. Go on, say hello. Say hello.
Can't you say hi?
You heard you, Mama. Go on.
Now, it ain't like we're leaving you forever. Rosebud's gonna ride you from Oregon as soon as we drop she and Josephine off at Aunt Adeline. Won't you, honey? See? And soon as Cielma gets out of Alaska, we're gonna send for you and all be together again. So. Well, say goodbye to your stepdaddy.
Say goodbye.
Mr. Doyle's gonna find his fortune in the oil boom in Alaska.
Ha! Huh. The only fortune he'll ever find is one somebody ain't watch him when he's around.
Eva Joe, I won't have no 12-year-old hairpin talking about me that way. And I mean it. Here, I'm leaving right now.
Oh. Dear, honey, you okay? Oh, honey.
Leave me be. Just get it over with.
Oh, okay, bye-bye. Bye-bye, little Freddy. Little Margaret Jean.
Eva Joe, can't you hurry?
Now, Rosebud, I want you to tell C.L. you're sorry, because I don't want you two fighting again. We got too long a ride. C.L., she didn't mean it, sweetie.
Margaret Jean, I'm going to miss you so much.
Aww.
My little babies, they're so cute.
Oh.
Joseph T., I don't think they can use your aunts here.
That's enough! Come on!
Come on, baby!
Come on, we ain't got all day.
Come in.
She says she's sorry for them awful things she said back there.
Come on.
I am sorry.
Hear that, CL? She is sorry.
Nothing but work for this family.
Oh, sure. Then how come you're always out of work?
I just had some bad luck, is all.
And it'll all be different in Alaska, you'll see. Why, won't they care in Alaska if he hides every time there's something heavy to carry?
Now you look him!
Oh, when are we gonna stop to eat, CL?
Paso Verde.
Paso Verde? We ain't ate since breakfast. Can't we stop sooner, CL?
We'll stop in Paso Verde. What do you want to do, blow us into Paso Verde?
Well, if I just sit, Jocko, I get nervous.
Yeah, well, go over the scam again, huh? The big man don't want no slip-ups, and I don't want you nervous.
Okay, arrive in Paso Verde at 4 p.m., start repairing roof of bank, work to bank's air vents at 5:30 when employees leave, widen air vents, finish at 5:55, Jocko slips in, dynamites the vault at 6 o'clock.
All right.
Wait
6 o'clock.
Probably lost it like it does with everything.
Mama, he says he didn't see it.
What do you mean he says that? How?
He has his own way of saying things, and I can understand it.
You can understand it. What's your sister gonna say about that? She never saw him. She don't know he can't talk.
I told you it won't make no difference, CL.
Well, how you know? You never even told her we was gonna drop him off.
With 5 boys, she'll be happy to have Rosebud to help out. And one more boy won't bother her, I'm sure.
Well, I'll tell you again, if she don't want him, we ain't taking him along.
What do you mean?
I mean, if she'll only want you, we're gonna find a place before we get to Alaska that takes dumb kids like him.
Oh, no, you ain't!
Car 17, I got a 211 in progress. Need assistance.
leaving, Joe. You better bring their supper back. If I eat with her, I'll get a heartburn for sure.
All right, CM. I'll be right there, all right, honey? Oh, I just don't understand you, Rosebud. How can you act that way to CL? You're lucky he's such a nice stepdaddy. He might get mad, but he ain't never hit you. Not once.
He's scared to. He knows I'd claw him so clean nobody'd recognize him.
I'll tell you what. You think up a real nice apology, and I'll bring you both back burgers and a double order of French fries, okay?
Give it, Joe!
Come and see Al, sweetie!
We ain't dropping just a tea off in no dumb place. You hear?
You see this? I got it 3 weeks back, but I didn't tell nobody. It's from Felicia Dotto. Remember him? That real old Mexican man who was so nice to us when him and CL was picking oranges. Well, anyways, he was also going back to Mexico to live alone, and he told me we could come there anytime we wanted to. And I promise you, Joseph T., I don't know how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna get us all there. Somehow.
Pardon me, sir. Do you have any room for us going north?
Oh, I'm sorry, we're headed south towards Los Angeles.
Well, thanks anyways.
Okay.
Joseph T., we're going to L.A. right now. So hurry, put this on. Oh. You pack your aunt's. And I'll fix it so it looks like we're sleeping up here.
Ah, there it is.
Yeah.
What did I tell you? Isn't that beautiful?
It's beautiful. You're beautiful.
Thank you, my dear. Thank you.
Sweet face.
Yes.
Do you think there's enough here to redo the dining room?
Would you please? Now, come on, let's go. We've got to put this away and get out of here.
Joseph T., and everything is just grand.
Getting heartburn if you wake her up.
Well, it's gonna be a long ride, so how about a little poker? don't tell me. You lost your cards. Well, don't worry about it. They was worn out and two weights was missing.
On TV, rich folks is always playing with the cards and things. I guess that's how they keep busy.
Wow. Look at all these games.
These folks must really be rich. I was right. See, two brand new decks up.
Look at all that play money. These folks must be afraid they're going to stop making it. Now, do you want to play with that instead of your old ones? Okay, but remember, you borrow them, you gotta put them back. Can you imagine what Mama will say when she finds we ain't there?
It's a bad blood than you
fire. She'll be back in
town. All right, all right. I'm being punished. You know that? I'm being punished for stealing that tire. That van don't give you no miles at all.
That child do anything to upset us. This is the worst thing she ever done.
Well, if you don't want to go to the hospital, maybe you'd like something to calm you down.
Oh, thank you. A chocolate milkshake would be just fine.
Jack, we better put out a statewide APB. This man saw the kids get into a big trailer that was being towed south by a white Rolls Royce.
White Rolls Royce?
Yes, sir. A new one, a convertible with red leather upholstery.
A new Rolls Royce with red leather upholstery?
That's right. Now get on that.
My kiddies! Somebody stole my kiddies! If it happens to them, I got no reason to go on living.
Somebody stole them. Oh, no.
Please, try not to get upset. Maybe you'd like that drink now, huh?
Oh, could you make that a double chocolate, please? Oh.
Joseph T., they're coming to where they live. Here, hurry. Give me your cards. They know they might want some stuff out of there. Come on. Your aunt!
We can just leave everything else here, can't we?
Oh, there are a few things I have to get. Oh, check the refrigerator and see if there's anything in there we can use tonight.
Aha! Why don't we take this upstairs and put it to bed? Huh?
Good idea. Oh, I almost forgot. Well, that's everything.
Close the door, will you, hon?
You better think before we jump, Joseph T. Now, that trailer's nice and warm and just sitting there empty. So, we can go stay in it and get an early start in the morning. Or, we can give her a try out there tonight. What do you think? That's what I think, too.
Quiet, Walter. Okay. Eric Hopkinson here. Recording for his daily journal. It's Friday. A boring day all day. Hit Louis Fairchild Whitney this morning in the carpool. Nothing serious, just minor difference of opinion. Results, as expected. Oh, blah. Suspended. Sent home by principal. Grounded by grandmother. Parents notified New York where father having business conference. Serious talk promised by father when they return Wednesday. As usual, it'll be boring. Saw four police shows tonight. All also blah. Solved each case before the first commercial. Well, I guess that's it. Oh, the new neighbors. The Lockharts are home again. Can't understand why my folks think they're nice. I mean, they never bring any gifts home from a trip. They're boring, too. Eric Hopkinson, signing off, over and out.
And authorities ask that anyone seeing the two children please phone their local police. It's believed they are now in the Los Angeles area. Meantime, C.L. Doyle, the children's stepfather, made an impassioned plea tonight in Paso Verde.
Whoever the rich folks is that stole our kiddies, I want them to know I only got $43 to pay a ransom, but I'll gladly give it, and their mom and me will find forgiveness in our heart if they'll just bring our kiddies back in one piece and alive and kicking.
Did you see that, Joseph T?
The Paso Verde Merchants Bank was dynamited and robbed today of $250,000 by two men who escaped despite roadblocks around the city.
Say.
Cheers.
Yeah, hello. Hello, Jocko, how are you? Yeah, we just got in, where are you?
At the garage, we've been waiting.
No, you haven't been waiting.
Oh, yeah, we just got back from playing gin rummy at my brother's house, and let me see. We've been here since 6 o'clock. Bubba broke even. I lost $2.50.
How's that?
That's much better. Now, will your brother testify to that if necessary?
My brother, of course. We're flesh and blood, ain't we? Anyway, he's afraid of me. Now, what about the split?
Pick up the trailer in the morning for repairs. Your share's in the closet.
In the morning? Why not tonight?
Because tonight, if the cops hear... begin to think that it was a Jocko Visalian job
in Paso Verde, and they come knocking at your door.
It is better that you're out $2.50 than ahead $125,000.
You got it?
Good point. Yeah, good point.
No, Jim. I mean, taking my night off is bad enough, but giving me 3 men to cover the whole...
Hold on just a second.
Catherine, where have you been? I've been calling all over for you.
FEMO files for Sergeant Abel. Paso Verde called. There's a bank robbery up there. They want a local dynamite specialist checked out.
Paso Verde? I just drew a job for them, too. It's an emergency. A couple of kids disappeared in a trailer. So I won't be able to move out of the house tonight. And I probably will miss the lawyer's appointment in the morning. So you'll have to make another, okay?
I see. Well, when, Jack?
Well, when you know that I'm off and you're not playing police lady, okay?
Okay. I'll let you know. Paso Verde again and still no clues up there? How many of these locals fit the bill?
A dozen. I listed them alphabetically from Irwin Arkins to Jocko Visalian.
A dozen. Couldn't you just find two or three on Kate? I'll be on these around the clock.
You said go look, so I looked.
Easy, Kate. Sit down. what goes with you and Jack tonight. Aren't things straightened out yet?
Sure. If you want to call it that.
Don't say anything yet, but we're
getting a divorce. With luck, I won't even have to talk to him again.
Look, if he doesn't want you to be a cop, why don't you just... Well, it'll be hard, won't it? I mean, divorced and working in the same division.
Why? It's a big division, and what law says I must work with him?
An order. Oh, come on, you gotta be kidding. Hey? Oh. Yes. Captain. Phillips, get in here. You've been assigned to me, Captain's orders. Well, now, I don't like it either. All right. Somewhere in this city, there are two kids who went on a joyride in a trailer. I mean, that's all it was, believe me. So I don't care if you have to turn every trailer you find in this city upside down. I want those two brats delivered to me in 24 hours or else. You hear me? All right, get going. Hold it, Phillips. Hold it. Not you. I don't want you getting lost in the dark.
Oh, now, wait a minute.
Now, I have an order for you. I want you to get on that phone and call every mobile home park, every trailer park that you can reach tonight, and then stand by that phone in case their folks call. They're on their way down.
Joseph T., wake up. I forgot to wake up, and we gotta go.
We stay up watching that old movie last night. Now we won't be able to go until he finishes out there.
Mrs. Lockhart and I drove a long way yesterday. We'd give an awful lot just to be able to sleep till noon. Like about $2 or... $5 to do anything but make that noise that you're making?
Open up. All right. If you don't open by the time I count three, I'll go and call the cops. One. Two. Yeah!
You call anybody and keep us from getting little Freddy or Margaritine away, so help me, I'll bust you upside down and sideways. You hear?
Who's little Freddy and Margaret Jean?
Our brother and sister we're gonna take to Mexico. And no one's gonna stop us. Not you, not the police, not...
Wait, where are they?
In a foster house here. And we gotta get them out.
But how are you gonna do it? Got any wheels?
No.
And how about a Mexican connection across the border? Got any?
No.
Well, we can get around that. But how we trigger the caper, that's what we'll have to organize first. You mind?
What?
Seeing someplace else.
Oh.
Now, you want to do this fast, right? Like tonight, maybe?
Yeah.
Good. The address of the foster house. You have it?
Yeah.
Right. We're lucky. That's only about 20 minutes from here by bike. We get you a bike. We alert your brother and sister about tonight. But first we put Heather to work on a connection to Mexico.
Who's Heather?
That chick down the block. Her dad ships stuff to Mexico every night in trucks. She'd get you on one if I asked her.
How do you know?
She thinks I'm foxy. Well, how's the keeper sound?
All right, I guess.
Good. It's safe to leave him here. Now, let me see. You need a hat, maybe a jacket so you won't be spotty. I'll be right back.
Wait. Why are you doing this?
Well, because I like what you want to do. And I want to help. Okay?
How do I know I can trust you? I don't even know your name.
It's Eric Hopkinson. And here's collateral until you do trust me.
I don't need no cahoots or whatever it is, but listen, I'm telling you here and now, if you bollocks this up for me, I'll bust you one you'll never forget. You hear, Eric?
I hear, Rosebud.
I ain't never met anyone like that in all my born days. Did you just have tea? But he sure sounds like he knows what he's doing. I just hope and pray we can believe him.
This is Louis Fairchild Whitney. He's got a bike, but he's too chintzy to loan it to us.
I'm not chintzy. I just don't think it's right legally.
His dad's a lawyer. And what he really means is he's too chicken to help.
What you're talking about is kidnapping, and that's a crime. Now, you just hold on. It ain't kidnapping and it ain't no crime. We're trying to get our own brother and sister back. So if you don't want help, just go. You can have my bike. Not less than you promise not to tell your dad or no police. I promise. I'll go get it.
I knew you'd get to him.
Why?
Louis cries at card tricks. Well, now I'll go get Heather, and I'll tell Louis to keep an eye on the trailer.
As soon as you called, I checked my father's desk. But there's a problem. The only truck to Ensenada for a week goes down at 6:30 tonight. So how'll you get the kids here? It'll still be light and everybody'll see.
Everybody'll see what? Kids on bikes like any other kids? Now, can you get the truck here at 6?
Oh, easily. My mother and father'll be out at the club for golf and then dinner tonight.
Great. But what can we put him in?
We just got a new refrigerator. Packing crate is still in the garage.
You're okay, Heather. I knew you'd do it. Now we case the foster house. So you go down below and check. If it's clear, throw up some pebbles.
All right. Don't worry, we'll help you. Oh, this is thrilling. A real kidnapping. It's just like a movie.
I just want to say that I know we'll get our kiddies back safe and sound. And just want to thank all the good folks who've been contributing so much to help us get them back from whoever took them.
Mrs. Doyle, your husband's been calling this a kidnapping. Now, isn't it possible your kids just got into that trailer for a ride?
No, it ain't. They love us too much to go and do that. Because they know how it'd worry us, what with a new baby coming and me with only $43 saved up from all my work.
Mrs. Doyle, is there anything you would like to say?
I don't want that thing in my face. Honey,
so you just be quiet now.
Who told you to leave the phone?
I just found a lead. A social worker named Miss Anderson. They put their two middle kids in a foster home yesterday, and that Rosebud girl really took off on him. If you want, I can check it out.
If that's true, it's our first lead. I better go with you.
Why?
Because I don't want it blown, and I don't have another real cop to send along.
I'm afraid my wife's too shook to do any talking, so I'd like to say here now, we don't take charity. But to save our kiddies, we will, even if it hurts, we'll be in a Colby hotel where there's kind enough to give us a room for free. In case any nice folks would like to call, the number is...
Thank you, gentlemen.
321-1321, Colby Hotel, room 12.
Thank you. That's it, fellas.
Room 12.
Mr. Doyle, what happened yesterday when you dropped off your other children at that foster home?
How'd you know about that?
Well, just tell me exactly. What did Rosebud say?
Now, it wasn't like we wanted to leave him, Lieutenant. You see, we had to. I was headed to Alaska.
Did she say anything about running away or going back to them?
Oh, no, sir. She fussed a little, but she didn't say nothing like that. So I know this kidnapped.
What's the address of that foster home? Do you have it?
You won't find nothing there, I guarantee you. I know you won't.
It's 529 Oak Street.
Hey! Who are you looking for?
Just some kids we promised to meet here.
They all left, but I'll tell you where they went. For a quarter. Deal?
Now, where'd they go?
That way.
Where that way?
That'll cost you another quarter.
Hey, now, wait a minute. Now, we had a deal.
Don't do these cheating you. You ain't very nice, you know that? You gonna tell us where they went? We're about to bounce you on your head. To the park, two blocks down. That's better. Now, you be nice to people, and they'll be nice to you. You hear? Come on, Eric.
I've never had two that unhappy before.
Psst. Don't move, it's me, Rosebud. This is Eric.
Hi.
He's gonna help me snatch you tonight to get us all to Mexico.
What time do you eat in the house?
About 6 o'clock.
What do you do before that?
Mrs. Ogle lets us watch TV or play while she cooks.
Little Freddy! Margaret Jean! Let's get some ice cream!
Will she let you play outside at 5 o'clock?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Then we'll come and get you. And if anybody asks anything, clam up.
What's that? Be like Joseph T. and don't say nothing.
Come on, children.
Go. We'll see you later.
I love you.
Bye-bye. Don't you want some ice cream?
Hold it, you guys!
Hey, stop!
You better keep your hands off!
Oh, yeah? Well, who says so?
We do, so leave him alone or I'll bust you one!
You hear that, Pete? She's gonna bust us one. Well, I'll bust you one and you won't forget it.
Woo!
Let's get out of here!
Hey! You looking for them foster kids, too? Like that guy and girl?
What guy and girl? How old were they?
Maybe 12, 13. I told them where the kids are. And I'll tell you, too, for a quarter. Deal?
Okay. It's a deal. Where are they now?
They went that way.
Look, that way doesn't tell me where.
That'll cost you another quarter. In the park, two blocks down.
Are you positive Rosebud didn't come down here and talk to you? Did anyone else talk to you?
Look, you can tell us because we're not going to hurt her. We just want to talk to Rosebud and Joseph T. That's all. I promise.
Well, I don't understand it. I mean, that kid in your front yard, he just sounded so positive.
Oh, well, that's Stanley, our little neighbor. He sometimes makes up stories.
Oh. Well, thank you very much, Mrs. Ogle.
I'm awfully sorry.
Okay, Jack, but I still feel there's something here.
Okay, I'll tell you what. When we get back to the station, pick up a car and stake out the house. But don't leave until that something shows up.
Somebody took the trailer away with Joseph T in it?
But I know who it was. There was a name and address on the truck, so I wrote it down.
It's not far. Would Joseph T know enough to stay and hide in the trailer?
I think so. He's awful smart.
Good. Then we'll get him. Now, Lewis, have Heather come to my house in exactly 1 hour. But in 45 minutes, you're going to keep my grandma busy until we can get Joseph T up to my room. Okay. Synchronized watches. It's 14:27 hours. Got it?
Huh?
27 after 2.
Oh.
Come on, Rosebud.
Calm down. How can I calm down when we just found 25 grand missing?
What do you mean just found? You've had the trailer all day.
We had real customers up until now. And we just opened the case and we found only 100 grand in your big joke.
All right, I'll bite my big joke. What?
Yeah, this here, the 25 grand in kids' play money that you put in instead of the real stuff.
Play money?
Dear, do you think this might be better?
I mean, are you kidding? Are you serious?
He wants to know if we're serious. Tell him.
Yeah.
You heard that, Mr. Lockhart?
There must be an explanation.
What do you mean there must be an explanation? Like what? Jocko, cop!
Uh-oh, I'll call you back. It's the cops.
Okay, now raise the rear of the trailer and look busy.
Yeah, right.
Sergeant Abel, how you doing? Hey, killer, shut up!
Hi, Jocko.
Hello, Sergeant. What are you doing over here?
Well, I just want to find out something, like where you two were last night.
Last night? Oh, we played gin rummy at my brother's house last night. Right, Bubba?
Oh, yeah, right.
Boy, no wonder the shower was flooded.
And, what time was that gin game?
I don't know, between, 6 and 11. And I lost.
$2.50.
Yeah, and if I asked your brother if this is true, he'd say right?
Well, why should he lie? We're flesh and blood, ain't we?
Yeah, besides, he's afraid of Jocko.
You mind coming out of there and showing me around a little?
Why, sure, Sergeant. What's up? What are you looking for?
Well, if I find it, you'll know.
didn't figure on that.
You get ready to go and put Joseph tea.
What about White Thing?
What? Come on, Pooch. Yes, come on. Pretty as can be, eh, boy? Come on.
Look, come on all you want, Sergeant Abel. We got nothing to hide.
Sure, make yourself at home.
Thanks.
That's kept locked, Sergeant.
Do you mind?
Joseph T.
Let's take a look at the garage.
Sure.
Mind if I look in this trailer?
Help yourself.
Hey, Jocko, you got an ant on your back there. I can see him.
Well, get it off. Don't stand there looking at it, Dumbo.
We're all gonna slide to that ant?
Attaboy. Oh, I know she likes you. Oh, my goodness, what a handsome boy.
Hey, Jocko, here's where those ants came from. This jar's full of them.
They're cute.
Cute. Get rid of them, you lunk.
Let me see that. Who owns this trailer?
Oh, some people named Lockhart.
Bubba may have found something here. The Pasaverde Bulletin says something about missing kids that hid in the trailer. And the little boy had a jar of ants.
Thank you, Bubba.
You know, a team like us shouldn't be broken up. You know that?
Yeah.
Hello. Lieutenant Phillips, please. Tell him it's urgent.
And did you know angelfish form a very strong attachment?
No. Louis, did Eric say what time he'd be back?
He said early, so it should be soon. Some people think angelfish fall in love.
With other angelfish, I hope.
And take goonie birds. They've been known to stop eating when separated. It's kind of sad, isn't it, Miss Hopkinson?
What's gotten into you, Louis? Have you met a girl?
What makes you ask that?
Love. It's all you've rattled on about since you came in.
I'll take that for you.
Oh, that's all right, Louis. I'll take it. Where is that Eric? I told his father everything was just fine. he missed his lunch and... Louis, do you know who he went riding with?
Oh, just somebody he met.
If he gets in trouble again today, did this somebody look nice?
Oh, very nice.
What was that?
I didn't hear nothing. Another thing about Goonie Bros.
Oh. Hi, Grandma. Boy, I'm starved.
Well, I should think you would be. Your lunch was ready an hour ago. I was getting very worried about you.
Well, I'm sorry. I was having fun bike riding, and I'm really sorry.
I couldn't even go shopping for our dinner tonight.
It won't happen again. I promise. And if it'll make you feel any better, why, me and Louis will go have lunch upstairs and watch the football games all afternoon. All right?
What a nice boy.
Tell me, Mr. Lockhart, were you in Paso Verde last night?
Yes, we stopped in Paso Verde for a few minutes last night. Why?
I'm afraid two kids missing from that area hitched a ride in your trailer without you knowing it.
Two kids hitched a ride in our trailer and we didn't know it? Well, that's impossible.
We have evidence that says these kids were in your trailer, sir.
You have evidence? Well, it's possible. I don't know. I was out there this morning. There's nobody there now. I'll promise you that.
All right, thank you. I'm sure we'll find them. Frank, I'll bet you dollars to donuts those kids are still in that neighborhood.
That's where the 25 grand is. Those kids have it. Did you hear what he said? Two kids in our trailer. They stole the money. Now, if the cops find them and the money, we're next. So we gotta find them first.
Sweet face, does that mean we can't redo the dining room?
Oh, would you please? Where do we look? How do we find them? Eric, he was out there this morning, and you know that little...
Yeah.
And you leave him to me.
Well, enjoy yourselves. I'll be back in a little while.
Bye, Grandma. Everything will be just fine here. Take your time.
Well, hello, Heather.
Hello, Mrs. Hopkinson. Is Eric here?
Well, yes, dear. He's inside. Come in. I'll have to unlock the door for you. He's just fixing his lunch, dear.
Thank you.
Go right in. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Soon need the address in Mexico. Come on, hurry.
You wait here, Joseph T.
Oh, this is so exciting. I can hardly believe it.
Yes, Douglas. My father wants a crate picked up at 5:30 sharp today and delivered to that Ensenada address I just gave you. Goodbye.
You are super.
All right.
Thank you, Eric. It wasn't hard.
What's going on?
Hold this! Joseph T, shoot him out! Go on,
me shoe now.
I'd like to apologize for what he'd done here, Eric. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
He's sorry, too. Awful sorry, and he hopes you ain't angry at him.
I'm not. Really, not at all.
Is that how he talks? Just by looking?
Yeah. He ain't never made a sound. And I'd like to thank y'all for what you're doing for all of us. It won't be forgotten. Ever.
Come on, Joseph T. We'll get you a cupcake.
Why, Mr. Lockhart, what are you doing here?
I'm waiting for Eric. I got a book for him. I got a present for him.
Oh,
from up north. I thought
how nice, and he will be surprised. Come in.
I've
been forgetting everything today. The front door, my shopping list. I was halfway to the market when I remembered that. Now, Eric's upstairs with his friend. You go right on up, and I'll look for my shopping list. I think it's in my other sweater. Here we are. Come in.
But Eric, I thought you and Louis were eating upstairs.
Well, we were. But Louis is on a diet, and I just couldn't resist your cupcakes.
I left my shopping list someplace. Oh, Mr. Lockhart brought you a present.
Eric, listen. Two runaway kids hitched a ride in my trailer in Paso Verde, and I didn't know anything about it. The cops are looking for it, and so am I, and I think it would be better for them if I found them first, don't you?
Why are you asking me this?
Because I think you know where they are. Do you?
No.
Now, what if I were to tell you that I consider what they did to be just a little mistake, and that I'm sure I can straighten everything out for everybody's satisfaction if they're brought to me before the cops get after them and really meet them? They're somewhere around here, right?
I found it in my other sweater.
If I were you, I would read that right away. It's a story called Crime and Punishment.
Thank you.
Oh, I don't.
You all right?
I'm fine, I'm fine. Don't worry about it.
Come on, let's go.
What are the police doing here?
They know you're in the Lockhart's trailer, and now they're gonna look for you.
What do we do if they start searching houses?
Make sure they don't search this house.
But how will we do that?
By helping them and letting them use this house as headquarters. Cops never search headquarters.
Are you sure? Are you positive?
Hello, Lieutenant. We just heard that you were making some progress.
Michael, not now. I'm sorry, but I just have enough problems without these kids being nervous about being interviewed on TV.
I won't mind, Lieutenant. I'm Heather Morgan, Mr. Carruthers, and I always watch your broadcast. I'd love to be interviewed on your show. May I see that again, please?
Well, how about it, Lieutenant?
Mike, I'm sorry. Please, I'll let you know if we find anything, okay?
Okay, we'll check with you later.
All right. Thanks. Well, how about it? Can you help us out?
No.
Now, there's something that you all should know. Right now, this whole neighborhood's being searched thoroughly. And there's a penalty for withholding information, a very severe penalty. All right. All right, you can all go.
Here's the names and addresses of the kids you wanted for your report, Lieutenant. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Oh, no, no, thanks. You've been a big help.
I was glad to help, sir.
You've been a big help.
Careful, children, careful!
Would you please?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Lockhart. You see, Eric's helping the police locate two little runaways. Unfortunately, these children hadn't seen them.
My wife and I wonder if we could come over and watch the football game on your set. Ours broke.
Well, of course.
Excuse me. Is Lieutenant Phillips here?
Well, yes. Oh, officer, come right in.
Thank you.
You just come right on over.
Keep searching and double check all the alleys. What are you doing here?
I heard you pinned down the location.
So you just decided to come here?
Yes, I thought you'd...
I didn't tell you to think. I told you to stay at your post until something showed up, right? Now go back there and do not leave until I give you permission. Is that understood, officer?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Oh, thank you. It's awful kind of you. Well, I'd like to talk about it first. Yes. And bless you. Did you hear Eva Joe? That man offered me a job in his factory. And an apartment for all of us. He's coming over here later to talk about it.
You're right, CL. Folks sure are kind down here.
Sure.
But shouldn't you have said yes right off?
Well, what's the good about just a plain job in a factory for somebody that's been on TV as much as me?
I told you the cops wouldn't find them, didn't I?
Yeah, but they will as soon as they start spending our money.
Look, with all that's happened, Eric can't keep hiding them. I just know it. Now, if we keep an eye on him, we'll find them, I guarantee it.
Well, how are we going to do that?
You two just get over here. I want you guys on the outside watching while I'm on the inside, okay?
Okay. Come on.
Where are we going?
The Lockharts.
Let's go over it again, huh?
Mr. Lockhart said that if these two kids come out of that house, we nab them.
Right. Now, what else did he say?
Well, he said,
come on, come on.
Oh, I remember. I forget.
He said that even if it ain't these two, we follow whoever it is, no matter where they go, because it means that something is up. You got that?
Well, that's a nice, clear picture, isn't it?
I'm sure glad you left somewhere to watch it on your
screen. I'm delighted. Oh, here are the boys.
Oh, Eric, thank you. And Lewis.
I must say, you boys are marvelous.
I must say something, too, Mrs. Hopkinson. You know, there are going to be games on all afternoon, and just because my wife and I are football fiends doesn't mean you have...
Oh, I love football. It's so colorful. There's the kickoff. Look at that damn deal, Crafty.
Oh,
no,
deal.
I gotta
go, bye.
Oh,
says he's sorry. I won't do it again.
It's okay. It's almost 3:20. So in exactly 2 hours, we climbed down the trellis and split.
You mean we're going down the trellis?
Sure, it's not hard. I always do it.
Uh-oh.
What's the matter?
It's broken.
How are we gonna get out?
Well, I don't know.
It's nearly 4 o'clock.
Maybe they ain't gonna make no move.
Lockhart ain't been wrong yet.
I remember one time.
Hey.
All right, no passing game.
No passing game. Dear, I hate to see you suffering like this over your team losing. Wouldn't you like a glass of water? They have used the timeout to stop a glass of water?
I want a glass of water. Yes. Oh, no, no, please, I'll get it. Just as soon as this plays off. Just a minute.
Both wide receivers to the left. Stabler's looking to the right. He's up.
The Rams can run it, but no. Red dogged him again.
The Rams have it. It's Dreyer at the 43-yard line. Stabler was hit. Fumbles the ball. The Rams have another turnover. Fumble recovery. They have 4 interceptions and 2 fumbles recovered to the Rams.
Hey. Hey, hey, hey.
What?
They ain't the ones in the paper, though.
Yeah. Hey, look. Hey, what do we do now, Jocko?
What Lockhart said, we followed him.
Who are those guys?
Probably some plainclothesmen. Let's shake him.
I think you lost them.
Come on, follow me. Eat or drink along the way?
He wants to know if you have some cookies you ain't using.
Sure, I'll get some.
Oh, wait.
Thanks.
Is there anyone in the house?
Oh, just the housekeeper. But don't worry. She's watching TV asleep.
Disturb you. I'm Lieutenant Phillips, and I'm sure you know Mike Carruthers.
It is Mike Carruthers.
Hi, Heather. Listen, I wonder if we might have an interview.
Of course.
Well, we sure pulled it off, didn't we?
Hey, you did it, you mean?
Yeah, I'm proud to know you, Eric.
Gee, thanks. But I'm a little sorry it's all over.
So am I. I'll miss you. I'll miss you too, Lewis.
Come on! Bring the camera over here. Put the lights over there.
So if she just tells us anything she knows, she could bring a family back together again. And Heather, all those people out there watching are sure going to appreciate it.
That'll do it. We're ready, Heather. And believe me, you'll photograph just beautifully.
Okay, Heather. The world's out there waiting.
Well, we only hid them and then helped in the kidnapping. Because we felt sorry for those poor children.
Wait, excuse me. What kidnapping?
Of little Freddie and Margaret Jean. We did it only so they could be together with Rosebud and Joseph T.
All right, who's we?
Two boys I know. It was just because we wanted to help them all get to Mexico.
Mexico? Where are they now?
The garage.
Stay with me, guys.
I think I could have done that a little better.
Well, I've got to be out here somewhere. You check that side of the house. Check the other side. Mike, check the front.
Lieutenant, come here! What? There they are. All right, hold it. Hold it!
All right, Mike, you take this one.
Eric,
how could you do it?
What are you doing here? Lieutenant, what happened?
These two not only hid the missing Doyle kids, they kidnapped their little brother and sister as well. All right, Eric. Where are they? The four of them. Where are they? Lewis? Look, I don't have to tell you what this could mean.
Eric. If you don't tell the lieutenant right now, I'll have your parents fly home tonight. And if they don't paddle you to a pulp, so help me, I will.
I just did it for fun.
Eric, tell him now.
There.
Come on! There they are.
All right, now. I'm Lieutenant Phillips, Police Department. Drop the ladder and come on down.
No!
Now, look, we don't want to have a problem here.
We don't want none, neither.
Well, then, let's drop the ladder. Because if you don't, I'm going to have to come up there and bring you down. Well?
No!
Huh. Don't, Lieutenant, stop!
Hey! Come on, now, get off the branch.
You gonna stay off this tree?
Now, you listen to... You listen to me. You go one more inch, and I will call the emergency squad, and they'll come out here with ropes and nets to bring you down.
You get anybody close with anything, and I'm gonna climb all the way up there.
All right. All right. But you can't just stay up in the tree.
I know that.
Then what do you want to do?
Go to our friend Felicidado Lopez in Mexico to live there. But we want a letter that says we can. But it's got to have one of them stamps on it that makes it against the law to break.
Now, look, the police department can't give you a letter like that.
Why? Ain't anybody there smart enough to write one?
Lieutenant, my wife and I feel somewhat responsible for their being up there. Listen, you can stay with my wife and me until things work themselves out, okay?
Thank you kindly, sir. But we ain't moving till we get that letter.
Thanks. I'm gonna call and get their folks down here.
Look, I'm gonna call downtown. Don't go away.
This is Mike Carruthers in Brentwood, where a tense and touching drama is taking place. In that treehouse are the two missing Doyle children.
What are they doing on TV?
The children say they won't come down until they are guaranteed, in writing, safe passage to a friend in Mexico. While authorities decide what to do, a large crowd is beginning to gather here to watch the drama. We have just gotten the name and address of that friend in Mexico. Our station is trying to contact him now. Meantime, the parents of the children are being brought down here to try to talk the children down.
Honey, wait!
Oh, Buzz, you come down off from that tree?
Why? Well, so we can love y'all. You don't know what that means. Not one little bit.
Honey, don't talk that way. You're gonna bring baby on here now.
That's all woman like you can do is have babies. Because it don't take no sense or love or anything to do that.
Rosebud!
And you ain't no better about raising them.
How can you talk that way?
You calm down, Rosebud. Folks have been very helpful to us. Why, this nice man here offered me a job and a place for us to live. Things will be different now.
How? The beer ain't any different here. So you'll get fired or quit again, just like every place else. Then you'll try and give us away again.
Now you take that back. Besides, folks seen us on TV and know it ain't true.
Go away! Just both of you, go away!
But I'm warning you! You get down from that tree or I'm gonna lock you up for the week and that's not all I'm gonna do.
Go away! 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 Go away!
I don't blame her. They're right.
Wait, what about my job in the apartment?
Forget it. I wouldn't touch you with a 10-foot pole.
Go away!
Now look what you've done! Look what you've done!
You better apologize right now.
Go away! Go away!
Don't ever call us again, Rosebud! You hear?
Go away!
Go away!
Go away!
Go
now!
Go away! Go away! Go away!
Go away! Go away! Go away! Go away! Go away! Go away!
Rosebud, the police in Mexico just called the station. They said Felicidado Lopez is dead.
No. It's a lie. He wants us there. See? Look, he wrote us. Just 3 weeks ago, he loves us. See?
He died last week, Rosebud.
Rosebud? Honey, won't you come down now?
Lieutenant, don't send me away. I want to help.
Kathy, there is nothing more we can do except get those ladders up there. Just hope she doesn't panic.
Well, can I talk to them first? Come on.
All right. Go ahead.
Hi, Rosebud. I'm Kathy, and I'd really like to help you if you'll let me. I'm sure they can find a foster home where you can be together and with people you like.
Then we'll wait here till they do that. We ain't taking no more chances.
Rosebud.
I want to meet them people first.
Oh, well, that'll take some time.
We lived in Happy too long. So we've got time.
Lieutenant, Mrs. Lockhart and I have no children of our own, and they seem like such nice kids. We'd be more than happy to take them in right now.
That's right.
Rosebud, did you hear that? Mr. and Mrs. Lockhart want you.
Mr. Lockhart, you gonna be nice to us?
Oh, of course, sweetie.
Can we wear clean clothes and go to nice school, stuff like that?
We'd be so happy to have you. You can have anything you want. Do anything you want.
We'll even redo a room for
right.
you.
Okay, we'll come down.
Hey, 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 hooray!
Hey, everybody, they're coming down here.
Where'd this money come from?
Mr. Lockhart's trailer. It's play money, and I gotta admit, Joseph T. was awful wrong to borrow it.
Play money?
Yeah.
Here. Officer.
Well, if it is play money, then these two clowns blew open the Passaverde Bank for nothing, right?
No, he didn't. That's real money, right, Mr. Lockhart?
Would you please?
All right, take him away.
That was real money, wasn't it?
There'll be no getting him down from there now.
Oh. I want them, Jack.
What'd you say?
I can't stand what's happening to them. I want them, Jack, for us. All four of them.
Honey, for us?
Yeah. Well, they need a mother and a father like us.
Yeah, but Catherine, how can you be a mother to four kids and still be a cop?
Oh, well, when they're much bigger, I can think about being a cop again. Oh, please say yes, Jack, please.
Rosebud.
Look. Officer. I mean, my wife here, Catherine Phillips. Well, she and I. We want you to come live with us. I mean all of you.
I didn't know cops were married cops.
Well, it happens. But if you say yes, Catherine will leave the police force.
If you say yes, Rosebud, I also promise you we'll love you.
Maybe you will, but he's too mean for that.
I am not.
Yes, you are. You holler and get mean when you're mad. I heard you with her in Eric's house.
Well, that was because we had a problem. Maybe it was because we didn't have children. So you could help us solve it by saying yes.
Yeah, but how do we know you won't get mean with us? Or that he even likes kids, or cares how they feel?
Look, Rosebud, do we have to discuss this now?
Dang right we do. I'm pretty sure about her, but I ain't so certain about you.
Now listen. I have never had any children. I don't know the first thing about raising them. I mean nothing. But if... I mean, if it takes changing to make everybody happy, then I want to change, okay?
Well, that sounds honest and worth a try. So we'll come down.
I love you, Jeff.
I love you, too.
You want to bust me one, Rosebud? Go ahead.
No, Eric. It wasn't your fault. You just ain't used to being scared is all.
You know something?
What's that?
I have a feeling that we're gonna make out fine.
So do I.